It may be the most expensive OnePlus phone yet, but with a huge notchless AMOLED display, a triple rear camera system, an in-display fingerprint sensor, and a front-facing camera that pops up, the OnePlus 7 Pro seems to be earning that price increase. But will all this added tech affect the OnePlus 7 Pro's repairability? Let's tear it down and find out. It just takes a little heat and some prying with our opening picks to start lifting away the rear panel. But to get the panel all the way off, we need to disconnect the cable that's home to the laser autofocus module and the flash. Once we're in, we're greeted with some very secure midframes. There are a total of 24 screws holding the top and bottom midframes in place, including two screws hiding behind white stickers. Now we can finally see the guts of the OnePlus 7 Pro, including the fancy lead screw mechanism that moves a front-facing camera up and down. Pretty cool. To get the motherboard out, we disconnect the battery first, and then a whole bunch of other cables, and finally remove a couple screws. This mostly frees the motherboard, but we still need to remove the bracket covering the front-facing camera cable and disconnect it. Then the motherboard lifts out. We disconnect the camera cables next and set the rear cameras free. This is a three-camera system that includes a 48-megapixel main camera, an 8-megapixel telephoto lens, and a 16-megapixel ultra-wide-angle lens that boasts 117-degree field of view. The motherboard is home to the 6 GB of Samsung-made RAM with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 octa-core processor likely layered underneath. And this thing must run hot. This is the most thermal paste we've seen in a phone in a long time. We also see the 128 GB of UFS 3.0 two-lane storage. Getting the front-facing camera out of the phone is some tricky business. First, we remove the lead screw mechanism. Then we have to remove the pin that drives the camera. Then we have to remove the bracket securing the front-facing camera to the case. And finally, we can pull the front-facing camera out of the top of the phone. Down at the bottom of the phone, we find a daughter board that's home to some microphones and the SIM card port. It only takes disconnecting a few cables and removing a couple screws to remove. Next, we turn our attention to the battery. And let's just take a minute to thank OnePlus for the handy battery removal tab. These tabs make battery replacements super easy. This battery has a typical capacity rating of 3,880 milliamp hours, which is an increase over the OnePlus 6T's 3,700 milliamp hour capacity. With the battery out of the way, we remove the modular USB-C cable. We love to see modular components like these. It's just kind of a bummer that the battery and the daughter board have to be removed before you can get to this frequently used and replaced part. Last out is the in-display fingerprint sensor. This in-display fingerprint sensor is the same type of optical sensor found in the OnePlus 6T. The sensor uses green light from the OLED display to illuminate your fingerprint so the optical sensor can see it and register it. We're left with a 6.67 fluid AMOLED display that has a 90Hz refresh rate, a resolution of 3120 by 1440, and a pixel density of 516 pixels per inch. It's an incredible display, too bad it's strongly fused to the phone's case, making replacements very difficult and time-consuming. With our OnePlus 7 Pro disassembled, it's time to reflect on repairability. The OnePlus 7 Pro scored a 4 out of 10. And here's why. On the upside, the battery can be removed first once you open the phone. It's only lightly adhered and comes with a pull tab for easy removal. Many components are modular and can be individually replaced. But on the downside, display replacements, which are the most common repairs, are not prioritized in the design. You have to completely disassemble the phone to swap out your screen. While the front-facing camera's new pop-up ability is really cool, the added mechanical element makes it more likely to wear out and more complicated to replace. And finally, the primary access point for all repairs, the rear panel, is firmly glued in place.